תחזה, זה, בשעדה דקודשה בריחו, השתכח בה בכנסת ישראל בעינון זמני נשתכח עמה, והיא מטרת ראותה לגבי בקדמתה ומשכת ליל לגבה, בסגיאות חיבתה ותאובתה כדנת מלאה מסתרה דימינה, וכמה אוכלוסים משתכחה בסתרה דימינה בחולו על מין, וכד קודשה בריחו את הר חביבותה וראותה בקדמתה, והיא יתרת לבטר ולה וזמנה דיו את הר כדין כולה בסתרה דנוקבה, השתכח ושמאלה התאר וכמה אוכלוסין קמים יתראה בסתרה דשמאלה בחולו על מין. כף על גי כתיב אישה כי תזריע וילדה זכר וגומר, מתי מתנינה על מת את האב כגוונה, תעלמה הילאה, השתכח ודה כדוגמה, דדה. Now we're going to hear the English.
Come and see, when the Holy One, blessed be He, is together with the congregation of Yisrael, Malchut, whenever He is with her and she rouses first a desire towards Him, and draws him to her with great love and longing. Malchut is filled from the right side, which is chasadim, that are considered male. And many legions of angels abide in the right side throughout the worlds. And when the Holy One, blessed be He, is the first to rouse love and desire, and Malchut is roused after, but not when the Holy One, blessed be He, does everything is considered female, which is Malchut. The left is awakened, and many legions are awakened on the left side throughout the worlds. In the same manner it is written, if a woman have conceived seed and born a man-child. This means that if the woman has an orgasm first, she gives birth to a boy. The reason, we learned, is because the lower world is in the likeness of the upper world, and the one resembles the other. Just as above, if Malchut awakens desire first, she is filled from the right side, which is considered male. So it is below.
In this section, there's tremendous secret about the whole idea of craving. Whenever there's awakening from the vessel, a true awakening from beneath, then the light of the Creator will reveal itself in a lasting way. And it's an opportunity for me to speak regarding this verse about the whole idea that called the four phases, which the Rav Ashlag explained how the original desire was created and how the vessel went through four stages until it reached its ultimate stage, which is awakening from the vessel, awakening from the woman. The woman represents the vessel within each one of us. So basically, the Zohar in this section helps us to connect to the idea, how do you create a true desire? How do you create a true vessel, a true yearning, that in return we can really connect to the light of the Creator in a full capacity? So the Rav Berg helped us to understand even deeper the idea of the four phases. How to build a real desire versus false desire. What is a false desire? That the awakening doesn't come from us. It means there's something that comes my way, that stimulates me, that excites me. As a result, I want it. And at the moment, I don't have natural stimulations and craving and desire, I'm not going to want it. But the idea is that since there is no coercion in spirituality, and the light of the Creator will never reveal itself unless we truly seek it. So at the moment that we lose craving and awakening, I want the light, I want the true blessing, the light will disappear. Because there's no coercion in spirituality, because the light cannot force himself. So the only way the light can dwell in us, only if we have a true desire, I want you, light. And light means the light of happiness, the light of joy, the light of relationship, the light of prosperity, the light of appreciation, the light of every aspect of lasting fulfillment, it's light. At a moment we don't have real awakening to want the light from within, the light will disappear. And that's the idea what the Zohar is saying. If the woman conceives first, if there's true desire from the woman, the vessel, the desire from within, then the light can reveal itself. If there's no real awakening from within, the light cannot really dwell and rest in us in a lasting way. So how do we build a true desire? Unfortunately, very often, when we stuck into our desire for oneself alone, and things seem to be okay in our life, there's no reason for me to have a big desire and a big awakening. Things are okay. My relationship is okay. My spirituality seems to be okay. My state of happiness seems to be okay. So I'm not even craving and wanting to receive more of better relationship, more spirituality, more growth. Things seem to be okay. I'm hearing so many times people tell me, I feel okay about my spirituality. I have other issues right now in my life. And according to the laws of the universe, since the only way the light can reveal in us, only if we have a true awakening and true desire, so whenever I'm getting to that complacent place, chaos gonna happen in my life that's gonna cause me to yearn and crave a light. I want you, I need you, I cannot do without you. It doesn't have to happen. If I will be able to maintain constant craving even to the things that I have in life, when I'm healthy, to continuously crave healthy, I have awakening for it. For every blessing that I have and I don't have, then the light always will be there to fill it up. Unfortunately, when I don't have craving because I don't see physically I need something, and I forgot the source of all blessing comes from the Creator, I will have to undergo chaos that will wake me up and will cause me to realize without the light you are nobody. You need the light of fulfillment, the light of prosperity, the light of the relationship, the light of spirituality. We need that protection. So the question is, how do we build desire without waiting for the chaos to come? Another indication that we have real yearning from within, craving from within, and not just waiting for the outside to shake us up, is appreciation. One of the indications that we have true yearning, that we're in a state of appreciation. Appreciation is a state of being able to remember when I didn't have. Like, it's very easy to appreciate second after you got a gift. Second after you made the deal, you closed the deal. Second after the miracle happened. Because we just see the difference between not having and having. Seeing the misfortune in front of us and the good things happen. Seeing the miracle after the statistic and probability showed me it's going to be bad. So the differences between not having and having, that is a state of appreciation. Wow, I'm appreciating, I'm overwhelmed. Craving will lead to a true state of appreciation. But the idea is, it's very easy to appreciate and to crave right after the miracle. How do we maintain craving and appreciation when things are great for a while? Without needing to compare to darkness. That's difficult because it's not in human nature. In our soul nature to crave, because our soul knows any second I can lose it all. And the soul knows the Creator gave me gifts every second. It's not just He gave me the gifts 20 years ago, it's going to stay forever. It's a new gift every second. The soul knows. That's the reason the soul constantly craves. But when we are ruled by our body consciousness and the ego, I already have it. What is the new thing I want in life? Forget about craving the things that I have. And that's why we're losing. That's why we go to ups and downs in life. Because things that we already have, we stop craving. We don't have the vessel for them. And we're going to lose it. Because if I don't have the vessel, there's nothing to hold the light. The source of every blessing in my life is the light of the Creator. Has to be a vessel that holds it. What is a vessel? Desire, but real desire. That awakening from within. I really want it. So that's what we're going to study now. How do I build, I really want it, in every area in life, in all positive fulfillments in life, without waiting for the loss? So at least we're clear why we want to learn the four phases. So in order to understand the four steps, we need to go back a little bit to the time of creation and learn what Rav Ashlag shared in 10 Luminous Emanation about how the original desire vessel in the endless was created. It might be a little deep and complicated, but if you watch it and listen to it a few times, I'm sure you're going to get it. So originally, the vessel was created in first phase. What is first phase? Passive desire. The vessel was created with all the light of the Creator in it, without craving. It was created like a baby has a $5 billion to his name. He doesn't know what he has. He was created with it. There's a passive desire. Of course he has it. It belongs to him. But there's no real I want. And there's no awareness even of what he wants or doesn't want. He was created this way. That's phase one. Passive desire. The vessel was there with the entire light without even knowing that he has all the light. Without knowing the difference between light or darkness. Phase two. The vessel suddenly starting to feel something, the first feeling. What did he feel? The nature of the light. What is the nature of the light? To give, to impart. And that's the beginning that the vessel first, wow. The vessel felt the light within him wants to give, that it's contrary to my nature of the vessel. I want to be like the light. I want to give, to impart, to empty myself completely. That was phase two. Tremendous awakening to give. What was phase three? What we call Ze'ir Anpin, or the state of vacuum, or the state of lack. As a result of the vessel emptying himself, the vessel created stage three, which is lack, emptiness, void. And then came phase four. Wow, only now I realize what I used to have in phase one, which is total abundance of the light. Now I really crave all the light that I used to have in phase one. And that's phase four. Phase one, having all the light without being aware I have the light. Phase two is tremendous desire to give everything away. Phase three is experiencing the lack since I'm not focusing on having, just giving everything away. Phase four, wow, I used to have so much of that light. Only now I'm realizing how much I used to have. I crave and I appreciate all the blessing that I have. And that's phase four. How does it correspond to our life? In life, what is phase one? Phase one is any blessings that came to us pretty easily in our life. Any blessing came, can be relationship, can be wisdom, can be spirituality, can be prosperity, can be health, anything. It's there. Whatever I desire, naturally I was attracted to do it, I was attracted to connect with somebody, attracted to a business. I had natural abilities, I was attracted to spirituality, I was interested in Kabbalah, I took Kabbalah 1, wow, blew my mind. Not much effort, just natural craving, natural desire. It was there, passive. I didn't do something special. Now, very often we will skip step two because we're not aware that we need to build the desire. And what will happen then? After the first honeymoon is over, this natural excitement is over, here comes the test. People say, you know what, it's over, I'm not interested, I don't want it anymore, I don't feel any connections, I'm not desiring it anymore, I wish I would but I'm not, and I'm moving away to next thing. Or after the chaos, I'm realizing, wow, it used to be so amazing, I should go back to it. But that is the passive way to deal with craving, not in a proactive way, in a reactive way. As we said before, things are great, step number one. Then I had to go through some chaos in the middle. That's build the craving. We don't want to go through the chaos. So how can we imitate the four phases of the vessel into our own personal life? That without going through chaos, we'll build the desire. And the answer is, phase one. Always will experience some phase one in life. Natural connection. Everything seemed to be okay. But we need to know, that's part of the secret of life. Always will be some end to phase one. I'm starting to realize I lose my excitement, I lose my motivation. Something starting to go down. That's the time to let stage one in. Which is, second stage is giving away. What is giving away? Giving away can be literally giving away, but giving away can making effort. Emptying myself, making extreme effort. Why I'm saying emptying myself? Because stage number two, I don't necessarily love to make an effort. It's not natural for me. Like the honeymoon is over, I don't feel as excited. That was stage one in the relationship. That's the time to invest in relationship. Instead of waiting when the natural next excitement will come and when the other person will excite me. No, that's the time to put energy in and effort. In my spiritual connection, when I feel this stage one, the natural excitement is gone, that's the time to put an effort. And I don't feel like making an effort, but that's the only way you'll build the true desire and you'll place that you'll appreciate. If it's a relationship, if it's a spirituality, and the only way that you'll know if something is for you or not. You don't judge because you're not excited anymore. You have to go through the four phases. So phase two is making an effort outside of myself, against my nature. That's the reason effort in this case considered to be giving, because it's outside of yourself. Stage three, as a result of that effort, will create within you some healthy lack and void. Not chaos lack. There's two types of lacks and voids in love. Chaos, lack of order, or that void or that lack that trigger true motivation. Because look at people who are very successful but very motivated. It's a bad lack, it's a bad void, they're motivated because of chaos? Not necessarily. We would love to have the real motivation, not because of chaos, because of that healthy lack, that realizing there's so much more I can go for. So stage two, making an effort, creating the lack, which will lead to stage four, I truly want the blessing that I had before. And when I have this true craving and true desire, that's when the fulfillment will come. That's when the love will come. That's when the real excitement and appreciation of the spiritual path will come. About that relationship will come. About that health will come. And after stage four, most probably after a while, we'll go back to stage one. And it's a constant cycle of building desire that is endless in our life. Between one, two, three, four. Having the natural motivation, the natural desire, the natural connection, no much effort. And if I'm not going to stop it, if I'm not going to push towards stage two, which is effort and pushing, I'm just going to wait until it will crash. And either it's too late or that will wake me up to want what I had before, but it's much more painful. And a lot of people are blinded because they are waiting for that excitement to stay forever. Where is my soulmate? That one that I will be excited forever without making any effort. Where is that spirituality that I'm going to get? I'm going to be excited forever with no effort. This doesn't exist in every aspect of life. Doesn't exist. Impossible. That's a real vessel. If I want a vessel that maintains blessing forever and clearly can see what's in it for me forever, what is the right relationship for me forever, what is the right spirituality for me forever, I need to be willing to go through the process and I need to expect that process. If you're new relatively to Kabbalah and you're in a state of excitement, great, it's part of the process. It's indication there's chemistry between you and the teaching, between you and another person. Absolutely, it has to be there. But remember, when it's going to start to decline and go a little bit down, that's the time effort. Even I don't feel like, make effort, give, share, spread, study more, make an effort, stretch, use tools with your heart, even though you don't feel like, extend yourself until it will build real lack and real motivation and appreciation and excitement. But it's much stronger than the first one because you earned it. And that's what the Zohar told us when the female awakening first. The first excitement, it's not awakening from us. The only way there's awakening for us, after I went through the difficult process and I made an effort and I gave myself up, then I will have awakening from within. That's real appreciation. That's real desire that allow blessings to maintain in our life. And it's a process that all of us have to undergo in order to have real connection to anything real in our life. If not, we have no real connection to nothing. Sometimes we might have talents that allow us easily to connect to things, but that's initial. That's initial. I'm not in touch with my talent unless I'm not going through these four phases. I'm not in touch with them. It's like a visitor, like a guest that is not really part of me. It's not part of my life. And that's why often people don't feel any connection to nothing. They feel lonely and empty. They might have 700 acquaintances, but not one friend, because they didn't go through the process of the four phases with that particular friend. Then there's emptiness, then there's void, there's no real connection. So the whole idea of this section of the Zohar, the desire has to come from the female, has to be for me. Natural excitement, it's not me yet. The creator created us in this world to be like him, to be the creator. He can give us everything for free, for nothing. But he wants us to go through the process that I wanted. Even though I lost my motivation and appreciation, I really want it. Because if there's no I, I'm not the creator. I'm just a robot. I'm the reactor. It's not a true desire. So we've learned now about the system of how to build real desire in life. That it comes. Because when that real desire is there, nothing's stopping me from drawing the light of the creator in blessings in every field and area in life.